Beacon Hill is one of the oldest, most historic, beautiful, and iconic neighborhoods in Boston. Not to mention, it is one of the most picturesque places in Massachusetts and even the country in some places. So in this video, we're discussing everything there is to do and see in Boston's Beacon Hill. So let's get into it. Hey there, welcome to the channel, or welcome back. My name is Jacob Peistrup. And real quick, if you're someone who is moving to Beacon Hill or another area of Boston, looking to familiarize yourself and really hone in on the right neighborhood for you and your lifestyle, whether you're buying or renting and you want help with that process, send me a text or send me an email. Let's get in touch. Let's schedule a call. Let's, you know, get that conversation started so we can get you here to Boston and find the right place for you in the Boston Metro. Getting to share this beautiful city with the YouTube community and everyone who is moving here is by far my favorite part of my job. I love it. I love the reach outs. I love that process of helping people who are moving to Boston, sometimes visiting for the first time in their life when moving to this city to call it home. So if that sounds like you and you want a little bit of help navigating this insane real estate market, then let's get in touch. Beacon Hill is such an iconic, beautiful, and historic part of Boston. There is a lot of history in this little neighborhood. There is a ton of architecture, landmarks, historic places that you will see if you come to Beacon Hill. Beacon Hill is gorgeous every day of the year. Whether it's winter, spring, summer, or fall, Beacon Hill is absolutely beautiful 24/7, 365. That is one of my favorite parts of Beacon Hill. The beauty, the charm, and the historical architecture you will see everywhere in Beacon Hill. Not to mention the fantastic location of Beacon Hill. It's right next to Boston Common, downtown Boston, the West End, and Starro Drive along the Charles River. It is, it's a perfect location when it comes to living in Boston. Now, Beacon Hill used to be actually one of three hills in the area, and it was called the Tri-Mount because there were three kind of mountains in this part of Boston. And over the decades, a lot of it was leveled down to make room for more development as the neighborhood grew, became more popular, and more people started moving into Beacon Hill. That being said, even if it's flatter than it originally was, as the name implies, it's a hill. So it can be pretty steep in some places. You got these narrow roads going up Beacon Hill. It's a hill. I'm not gonna blame you if you need to catch your breath once you get to the top. If you walk from the bottom all the way to the top of the hill, it can be pretty steep. I mean, hey, when we do showings at properties in Beacon Hill, we're not just there to admire the architecture and the history. We're there to get a workout in too. That's how we do it here in Boston. We like to kill two birds with one stone. My job is all about multitasking, trust me. Now, Beacon Hill has a lot of architecturally and historically significant, you know, houses, museums, and landmarks. One of the most photographed streets in the country is actually in Beacon Hill. It's Acorn Street. If you look up Beacon Hill, probably half the pictures you will see on Google are of Acorn Street. It is impossible to miss that cobblestone road of Acorn Street when you're looking at pictures of Beacon Hill online. I mean, it's details like that that Beacon Hill is known for. The brick and cobblestone streets, the gas lights, the original architecture, and the details from these homes that go back to the early to mid 1800s in some cases with these houses in Beacon Hill. In terms of architecture, a lot of the buildings you're gonna see in Beacon Hill are going to be these brick, federal style, Greek Revival, or Victorian row houses. Now, not to be confused with the traditional Boston brownstones. The brownstones are townhouses, a little bit different than the row houses. They're more 3D in shape. You got the bay windows coming out, and the townhouses are a little bit different in that you will see differences from one to the next, whereas with the row houses in Beacon Hill, it's much flatter, and they typically share a more common facade. It's more conforming in terms of the style, and they all kind of look the same. With the townhomes, sometimes you can tell the differences from one to the next because they have a different style. Even if it's, you know, small, you can see subtle differences from one to the next. But they're similar in the fact that they have a shared common wall between units, which acts as the property line from one house to the next. Beacon Hill is also home to the iconic Massachusetts State House. So this is the state capitol for the Commonwealth of Massachusetts on top of Beacon Hill, overlooking Boston Common. It's impossible to miss. Now, as far as the actual neighborhood of Beacon Hill, there are really three distinct regions that Beacon Hill has, and those are the South Slope, the North Slope, and the flat of the hill. Starting off with the South Slope, this is everything around Beacon Street towards the south of Beacon Hill, right next to Boston Common. Now, this part of Beacon Hill was developed in the early 1800s for the Boston aristocrats, called the Brahmins. They were really the prim and proper elite class of Boston, and they lived in the South Slope of Beacon Hill. And the mansions they lived in are still there to this day, right across from Boston Common. Now, the North Slope is a little bit different from the South Slope. Back then, it was a lot of smaller wooden and brick houses, and they were much closer to the Charles River back then. These were like waterfront properties because over the centuries, you know, they've used landfill to kind of build out the neighborhood more for development. So they are further away from the water nowadays than they were back then, where they looked out right over the Charles River. Now, the North Slope has a diverse history of, you know, architecture and demographics as far as different people moving in and out, different houses being built, but in 1963, it was declared a historic district. And the purpose of that was really to, you know, protect the history and the architecture in Beacon Hill. A lot of Beacon Hill is very protected. It's difficult to modify the exterior of these buildings if you're making any major changes or renovations. And the purpose, you know, they want to preserve the history, the architecture, and those original details that go back to the 19th century for these homes in Beacon Hill. Now, the third region in Beacon Hill is the flat of the hill. And of the three areas of Beacon Hill, the flat of the hill was the last to be developed because, as I mentioned before, Beacon Hill used to have three hills. It used to be a lot taller, and the elevation was a lot higher than it is today. So what they did, they leveled the hill a little bit. They took, you know, the dirt they excavated, and they put a lot of that into the Charles River. They used landfill to build out the flat of the hill to make room for more development in Beacon Hill. So as Beacon Hill was growing, becoming more popular, and more people moving into the area, they were flattening the three hills and taking that dirt they had excavated and putting it into the Charles River to build out the rest of the neighborhood, which then became the flat of the hill. And the flat of the hill is where you will see Charles Street, which is kind of the main street going through Beacon Hill. And this is where you will see bars, restaurants, small stores, and boutique shops in Beacon Hill. A lot of which will be locally owned businesses. You're not gonna see a lot of, you know, big brands in Beacon Hill. It'll be smaller businesses, family run sometimes, more locally owned than, you know, the bigger corporate businesses. And a lot of these places can be a great stop for food or drinks if you're on your way to a Bruins game, but don't want to deal with the hassle and the chaos of going somewhere in the West End. Speaking of the West End, Beacon Hill is right across the street from MGH, which is in the West End. So this is the Mass Gen Brigham Hospital. It is huge. It brings a lot of healthcare professionals to this area, students, residents, researchers, nurses. A lot of people come here because MGH is right across the street. Now, with everything Beacon Hill has to offer, from the location, the architecture, the history, some beautiful properties in Beacon Hill, it is one of Boston's most expensive neighborhoods to live in. If you're looking to own a little piece of Boston history by buying a single-family row house in Beacon Hill, it'll cost anywhere from $2 million to $22 million to live in Beacon Hill for a single-family row house. Now, condos in Beacon Hill are easier to find and also at lower prices. So you can have condos in Beacon Hill that will have a lower barrier to entry compared to the single family row houses. Condos will go anywhere from $500,000 up to that same price point of $18 to $20 million like the single families. But you will see a lot more options for condos in Beacon Hill between that $500,000 and $1 million price point, where with single families, that doesn't really exist in Beacon Hill. Now, whether you're buying a single family row house or a condo in Beacon Hill, what you gotta remember and keep in mind is that Beacon Hill is very old and it's very historic. So a lot of these row houses or condo buildings will go back to as old as the early 1800s in some cases if you're looking to buy in Beacon Hill. Now, in a lot of cases on the interior, these could be very nicely updated, renovated, and converted, whether single family or condo, but the exterior of that building still goes back to the 1800s. Beacon Hill is primarily a lot of, you know, historic homes and buildings, so there's a lot of of redevelopment, but not as much new construction. There's really only a few exceptions in Beacon Hill for new construction. So a couple examples if you're looking to purchase in Beacon Hill are gonna be the Signet Residences on Mount Vernon. These are newly converted condos in Beacon Hill. You have Joy at Beacon Hill, which is 3, 4, and 5 Joy Street. Again, these are converted condos. Now the one big exception to new construction in Beacon Hill is the Archer Residences. So this is a brand new full service luxury condo building with 67 units just built in Beacon Hill. One of the biggest recent developments in Beacon Hill, and these units have been priced between $1 million and $18 million at the Archer. So again, that is an exception to it. It is not easy to find something that is new construction in Beacon Hill. A lot more options will be renovated and converted, but still in historic buildings. Now here's the sneaky part with some of these listings in Beacon Hill. If you're looking at an online site like Zillow or Trulia, is that when us brokers input a listing, it asks us for the year built and or the year converted. But people don't always put in both years. And sometimes they don't always know the year it was built. So if you see a listing in Beacon Hill where it looks like it says it was built in 2015, 2017, 2019, whatever it is, chances are that's the year it was converted and renovated, but the building itself still goes back to the 19th or 20th century. Just something to keep in mind. Again, sometimes the year built isn't always known, especially when it's from the 19th century. Sometimes they forget to put it in. You can give the benefit of the doubt, but keep in mind a lot of these buildings are from the 19th and 20th century in Beacon Hill. But you will have beautiful options in Beacon Hill from all years built across all price points. So if you're looking to own a little piece of Boston history, Beacon Hill is a great place. You can absolutely do that. So if you're looking at moving to Beacon Hill or another area in the Boston metro, if you want help with that process of renting or buying, whatever it is, by all means, please send us a text or send us an email. Let's get in touch and get that ball rolling so we can get you here to Boston. Again, always feel free to text or email. Let's get in touch, set up a call, and go from there. So with that being said, that is going to wrap up this video for today. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. I hope you take care, have a great day, and I will see you in the next video right here on the Living Boston channel.